Thank you. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
Of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the memorial of Saint Catherine of Siena, Virgin and Doctor of the Church. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and shortcomings and ask the Lord for His mercy and pardon. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call us sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who set Saint Catherine of Siena on fire with divine love in her contemplation of the Lord's Passion and her service of your Church, grant through her intercession that your people, participating in the mystery of Christ, may ever exult in the revelation of His glory, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. There was an attempt in Iconium by both the Gentiles and the Jews, together with their leaders, to attack and stoned Paul and Barnabas. They realized it and fled to the Lycaonian cities of Lystra and Derbe and to the surrounding countryside, where they continued to proclaim the good news. At Lystra, there was a crippled man, lame from birth, who had never walked. He listened to Paul speaking, who looked intently at him, saw that he had the faith to be healed, and called out in a loud voice, stand up straight on your feet. He jumped up and began to walk about. When the crowds saw what Paul has done, they cried out in Lycaonian, the gods have come down to us in human form. They called Barnabas Zeus, and Paul Hermes, because he was the chief speaker. And the priest of Zeus, whose temple was at the entrance of to the city, brought oxen and garlands to the gates, for he, together with the people, intended to offer sacrifice. The apostles Barnabas and Paul tore their garments when they heard this and rushed out into the crowd, shouting, "Men, why are you doing this? We are of the same nature as you, human beings. We proclaim to you good news, that you should turn from these idols to the living God, who made heaven and earth and sea and all that is in them. In past generations, he allowed all Gentiles to go their own ways. Yet in bestowing his goodness, he did not leave himself without witness. For he gave you rains from heaven and fruitful seasons, and filled you with nourishment and gladness for your hearts." Even with these words, they scarcely restrained the crowds from offering sacrifice to them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Not to us, O Lord, but to your name give the glory.
Not to us, O Lord, but to your name give the glory.
Not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name give glory. Because of your mercy, because of your truth, why should the pagans say, "Where is their God?"
Not to us, O Lord, but to your name give the glory.
Our God is in heaven. Whatever he wills, he does. Their idols are silver and gold, the handiwork of men.
Not to us, O Lord, but to your name give the glory.
May you be blessed by the Lord who made heaven and earth. Heaven is the heaven of the Lord, but the earth he has given to the children of men.
Not to us, O Lord, but to your name give the glory. Please stand.
The Holy Spirit will teach you everything and remind you of all I told you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever has my commandments, observes them, is the one who loves me. Whoever loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and reveal myself to him." Judas, not the Iscariot, said to him, "Master, then what happened that you will reveal yourself to us and not to the world?" Jesus answered and said to him, "Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our dwelling with him. Whoever does not love me does not keep my words. Yet the word you hear is not mine, but that of the Father who sent me. I have told you this while I am with you. The Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, He will teach you everything and remind you of all that I told you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
It's Monday, and what a beautiful way to start both working and study days with all of us gathered here around the table of the Lord. And as we start this reflection, my dear brothers and sisters, let us remind ourselves that it is God's desire to live with His very special creation, and that special creation or creature is you and me. The Lord said in our gospel, "Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our dwelling with him." Of all creatures, imagine God wants to dwell in you. Sa atin, gustong manahan ng Diyos. But before that, there lies a condition. Whoever loves me will keep my word. At ito po yung simpleng pagtitiwala at pagbibigay ng puso natin sa salita ng Diyos na ating binibigyang pansin at pinagninilayan. Yung salita ng Diyos na siyang pagmamahal natin at pagbibigay din natin ng ating pag-ibig sa Diyos. And how blessed are we that with all the means of embracing, reflecting, and reading the Word of God, all the more we have the capacity that as we reflect the Word of God, we also express how we love God. Pero babalik muli po ako sa aking sinabi kanina that of all creatures, God wanted to dwell in you. A life with God, a person filled with God, can really express goodness and show how God is to live and who is the face of God in this world. And we heard it in our first reading today. Paul and Barnabas, these disciples, filled with God, healed a crippled man. But as men filled with God, they are not filled with a lot of themselves. Because, my dear brothers and sisters, once we are full of God in our life, in this life, we step backward and let God shine in this life. At malinaw sa kanilang dalawa iyon. Nung napagaling nila ang taong ito, hindi sila ang namayani, ang Diyos ang nagliwanag sa kanila. At ganun ang mga taong nananahan ang Diyos. Pinapaliwanag ang Diyos, umaatras ang yabang sa sarili. My dear brothers and sisters, the perfect place for God to dwell is at the very heart of His loving creation, and again, that is you and me. Ikaw, tayo po, ang tumpak na tahanan ng Diyos. Gusto ng Diyos na mapuno tayo ng Kanyang presensya. At sa mga gagawin nating kilos, mapakita natin na puno at namumuhay sa atin ang Diyos. At sa bawat mabubuti at tapat na gawin natin sa bawat isa, we have exclaimed this a while ago, we give God the glory.
Please stand.
With confidence, let us now raise our hearts to God the Father, who guides us through His Word. For every petition we shall say, Father, keep us in your love.
Father, keep us in your love.
That the Church may live the spirit of the Gospel and seek God's will in her ministry of service, let us pray to the Lord.
Father, keep us in your love.
That we may all work for justice and human dignity, especially for the weak and the poor, let us pray to the Lord.
Father, keep us in your love.
That as a community, we may support and uplift one another with the love and gentleness which the Lord has shown us, let us pray to the Lord.
Father, keep us in your love.
That those who are sick in mind, body, and spirit may find complete healing, let us pray to the Lord.
Father, keep us in your love.
That the dead may enter the place of Christ, may enter the place Christ has prepared for them, let us pray to the Lord.
Father, keep us in your love.
We pray in silence for our own intentions and lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, keep us in your love.
Almighty Father, hear our prayers and open our hearts to welcome and love our needy brothers and sisters. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, the saving sacrifice we offer in commemoration of Saint Catherine, so that, instructed by her teaching, we may give ever more fervent thanks to you, the one true God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence. by which you call human nature back to its original holiness, and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Catherine of Siena, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to say, "Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Sure.
Please stand.
Let us pray. May the heavenly table at which we have been fed, O Lord, confer eternal life upon us, as even in this world it nourished the life of Saint Catherine, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, the Mass has been offered.
Thanks be to God.